Greetings. How are y'all doing out there today? I am Pastor Wilmer Browder. This is the First Church of Social Media. I hope y'all are having a marvelous and wonderful Sunday. I know I am, just because of the simple fact is he woke me up this morning. I don't know about you all. I ain't gonna worry about what happened yesterday. I ain't gonna worry about what happened last week. I ain't gonna worry about what happened last month, because the simple fact is he gave me another day just to cast my burdens over to him. Well, I have a great and marvelous word for you all today. But first, since he thought about us this morning, we're going to simply give him some praise and worship so we can saturate our atmospheres in the mighty name of Jesus. I do not own the rights to this music. I do not own the rights to the music. In the mighty name of Jesus. I do not own the rights to this music. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. If you know the words, you can join in and sing along with us. How many of y'all carry the burden? But you ain't got to carry it no more. Hallelujah. Do not own the rights to this music. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Yes, God. I hear your invitation. Yes, God. To let it all go. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Hallelujah. How many of y'all been in this situation? How many of y'all are in this situation right now? This is what you need to do. Yes, God. Had a plan from the start. I don't own the rights to this music. Glory to God. Your son for redemption. Hallelujah. The price for my heart. Yes, God.
And I don't have a context.
Yes, God.
For that kind of love. I don't understand it. I ain't comprehend it. All I know is I need you. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. My heart not hiding, I know in the rain.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, God. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon. My soul needs a friend. I'll run to the Father again and again. I'll run to the Father. It's all in your grace. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Run to the Father. Your heart needs a surgeon. Yes, God. A soul found a friend. Run to the Father again and again and again. He's there for you. Hallelujah. 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 And again and again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. I run to the Father again and again. He says, my heart needs a surgeon. My soul needs a friend. He says, no need to wait. Run to the Father again and again. Glory to God. I just love that song. God put that song on my heart this morning because somebody needed to hear what they need to do in a tough situation. Well, again, I am Pastor Wilmer Browder. This is the First Church of Social Media. I hope you enjoyed our little praise and worship moment. Now, let's get right into the word for today. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Today's message is coming out of Romans 8:28. Again, Romans 8:28 is a very popular, familiar scripture. And it reads as follows. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. Thank you for the reading of the word. Today's message is entitled The Turmoil, the Turbulence. Again, today's message is entitled The Turmac, the Turbulence, the Turmoil. On August 1st, 2021, American Airlines had an operational meltdown. Their hub, in case you didn't know, is located in Dallas, Texas. And on this particular Sunday, they had a meltdown. This meltdown was so powerful, it took effect across the world. They had canceled 874 flights between cancellations and delays. This ripple effect affected everyone across the board. If you was in, no matter what airport you was in, no matter what time frame you was in, this meltdown just rippled across the nation. They said it was due to weather, and it was due to some operational things that was going on the staff. But the simple fact is that this had cause the people across the world some type of effect in their life. And I know sometimes we go through certain things and certain situations, but let me tell you on this August 1st how it went down. It simply reminded us right here as we look in the text today, and Paul is talking to us as he was first talking about the law cannot save you from sin. And then he goes on to say, Paul says, oh, what a wretched man that I am. Who will deliver me from the body of death? I thank God through our Lord and Jesus Christ, our Savior. So we find ourselves, first of all, on the tarmac. The tarmac is simply a material used for surfacing roads or other outdoor areas consisting of crushed rock mixed with tar. It's a runway or other areas simply called a tarmac. One of the horror stories that I heard was that simply the flight was delayed and the people were on the tarmac. This is where the plane either lands or takes off. was on the tarmac for hours. One situation, they was out there for over several hours without no AC or no water. Sometimes we don't understand situations, and we probably are wondering, why is this happening to us? Have you ever been in a situation and caught up and you felt like you was these people on the tarmac where you were stuck in the airplane, you couldn't move, you couldn't go nowhere, the situation you was in, you felt the same way. You didn't know what to do. It was nothing really you could do about it. But yet you sat there and wondered, saying, why? Why me, Lord? Why do I have to go through this? This is the worst day of my life. But the simple fact is you don't even realize that, number one, it's not simply quite the worst day of your life because you're living. Somebody didn't wake up this morning. But I understand because of the situation and the how you don't know how you're going to get out and you don't know how long you're going to be sitting here. A lot of times we just take things for granted and not understanding what and why and who. But Paul lets us know right here in the scripture, he simply said that all things work for our good. Now, I know you're sitting here wondering, how can this work for my good, Pastor? If I'm on this plane, I'm on the tarmac, I'm stuck. Number one, I'm late to where I gotta go. I'm going to miss my connecting flight. How is this working all for my good? Well, I'm going to simply let you know one simple way. The simple first way that I realized that God gave me revelation on is simply because you're sitting on a tarmac. This is out of your hands. You're out of control, but yet you have to sit here. And while you're sitting there, things are going on in your mind to cause you turbulence, to cause you turmoil. Okay, turbulence is simply a violent or unsteady movement of air, water, or some other fluid, simply conflict or confusion. And here we are, we're sitting on the tarmac, we're stuck, we can't move, this is out of our hands, we're not in control, we don't have no power, we feel powerless. I know, and sometimes you feel like that in your life. You feel like you're stuck in a situation, you don't know what to do, you feel powerless, and you're trying to figure out, what is Paul talking about in Romans 8:28? How is this situation gonna work for my good? Well, I'm gonna let you know. The first way that it works for your good is, number one, is you have to develop some type of patience, simply. We all need patience in life, because if we have patience, we'll begin to understand, and before we overreact, we simply be patient. That's a form of humbleness. See, God puts us in search of situations to get you a clear understanding so you can learn how to be patient. I understand that sometimes while we're being patient, we might become a patient. A patient is someone who's sick, someone who needs rescue, and someone who needs some type of medicine in your life. Well, I'm here to tell you, while you're being patient and becoming a patient, the Lord and Savior is already in control. He is already knows your beginning and your end. He knows that you're feeling some type of way because you're in this situation, but he wants you to learn how to be patient. He wants you to become understanding. He wants you to have grace and mercy on the pilot, on the stewardess, or whatever the people you come in contact while you're on the tarmac. He wants you to understand that, simply understand that I am in control, the Lord says. You're sitting on the tarmac. You're going through this turmoil, which you feel like, and you just don't know what to do. He simply is saying, be patient. Let peace be still in your life. Allow him to take care of whatever situation you're in. So we understand why these people are sitting on the tarmac. We understand what Paul is talking about in this particular verse. Now we move on to the turbulence. So I want you to understand that when you're on an airplane and you're taking off the tarmac, I want you to understand, as you go up in the air, that you get settled, you're flying to your destination, and as you're flying, you might feel the plane shaking a little bit, and you're getting frantic in a way. You're feeling scared. You don't know what's going on, but the plane is shaking. The wind is shaking the plane real bad. This is simply turbulence. And sometimes in life, we go through certain situations that shake us up real bad. You know, you don't know why you're going through this. You don't understand it. And it just hurts. And it feels like you're about to fall out the sky. And the same way these people felt on this plane that day, once they finally took off, they was going through the turbulence. And sometimes in life, we don't understand why or when. We just want the Lord to interrupt and intervene upon this situation, saying, Lord, help me as I go through this turbulence, Lord. I want you to help me, Lord. So I want you to understand what Paul is saying while you're going through the turbulence. He is simply saying in the scripture, he's saying that all things will work together for your good. How is it that whatever you're going through, this bad situation, how is this going to work for me, Lord? That would be my first question. How is this pain going to help me? How is this hurt going to help me, Lord? You got to look at the bigger situation sometimes. That's why we have to step back and just allow God to move. And he'll show you and give you understanding of why you are going through. He will give you understanding of what you need to do as he is taking care of the turbulence. The simple fact is, people, that just like in the first part, while the people were sitting on the tarmac and they was learning patience, there's something else we need to learn while we're in the turmoil. We need to understand the simple fact is, people, that God is in control. And I understand the fiery darts are coming at you and you don't know what to do, but simply just stand still. Because while you're becoming patient, he's letting you know that you are the patient and he's the doctor. You see, you got to allow that doctor to come in to give you the proper medicine so you can get through your situation. Whether it's humbleness, whether it's just you being still, and understanding that God is in control. So as we find out, as the people are on the tarmac, we understand the patience. And then the people that are in the air, they're going through the turbulence. We understand that sometimes in life, we have turmoil. Turmoil. Turmoil and turbulence seem to go hand in hand. Because it's like a situation where that is coming at you, and it's like a great disturbance. The same similar thing as turbulence. So we find ourselves on the tarmac, and then we find ourselves in the air with the turbulence, and then we find ourselves going through turmoil. And I wonder, you're probably sitting here wondering, Pastor, how does this all have to tie in to this scripture that Paul is talking about? Well, we have to understand what Paul was talking about before the scripture. Paul was talking about, simply, he was saying that this is basically from the suffering to the glory. Because simply on a tarmac is when a plane is taking off or the plane is landing. So simply, in order to get to your destination, you have to go through the turbulence and turmoil, because on the other side of that is the glory. It's the glory of God. It's your destiny. It's what you are called for. It is your purpose in life. And understand that to get to your purpose in life, your destination, your destiny, there are some things you will have to go through. You will have to go through that turmoil. You will have to go through that turbulence, because the glory of God is waiting for you. Who am I talking to today? Do you need a specific itinerary so you can take off and or you can land? Because you are getting ready to birth whatever it is God has for you. Whatever it is, your destiny is, whatever your calling is, whatever it is, it is getting ready to happen. And I want you to know that the glory of the Lord is waiting on the other side of that tarmac or that turbulence or that turmoil. Whatever it is you're going through, there's a blessing in disguise in it. It's like a diamond in the rough. And I simply want you to understand that no matter what you're going through, no matter what has happened to you, I want you to understand Paul says that all things will work together for your good. I know you might cannot see it right now, but I want you to know that it is going to happen. There's going to be a sound that is going to be released. A sound that opened the heavens upon you to pour out a blessing. I know you might can't see it right now. I know you might can't hear it right now. But I want you to understand that all things work together for your good. Whether you're on the tarmac or whether you're in the airplane and you're already taking off and you're having turbulence in your life and you feel like the turmoil that's going on around you is tearing up your heart, is tearing up your mind, I want you to know that all things work together for your good. It will be a total 360. It will be a clear understanding. As we get ready to enter into this new week and this new day, I want you to understand about just like the people were sitting on the tarmac. They were sitting out there with no air conditioner, no water, didn't know where to go, didn't know what time they was leaving. The same way you're sitting there now, you're sitting in this mess, you're sitting in this situation, you don't know how it's going to end, you don't know how you're going to get on to the next day, you can barely breathe, you feel like the pressure is coming against you. I want you to know that all things work together for your good. And remember that the temporary situation you're in is just that. It's temporary. Because when you're sitting down in a situation, it's only for a moment. You can't sit but so long. And God is already in control. So let cast that burden over to him and get ready for your new week. Get ready for the birthing. And I want you to know, whatever it is, just allow God to take over so that you can learn how to be patient while you're being a patient. Know that who the doctor is in your life. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but maybe you have never, ever even heard of God. Maybe you don't even know who Jesus is. But I'm here to tell you, as we're sitting on the tarmac and we're getting ready to take off to our destiny, we want you to be along with us on this plane. We want you to go ahead and get your ticket now. Look, all you have to do is email us at firstchurchofsocialmedia@gmail.com. Yes, get your ticket right now. The ticket is simply salvation. You can have that relationship with him. He wants you to be in relationship with him. He wants you to take this next trip with us as we fly on to our next destination. As we rise above all the darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. Maybe you had that relationship with him. Maybe you was on the plane, you was on the tarmac, but you had to get off because of emergency situation, which caused us to basically lose our relationship, our connection with the Lord. That's simply backslide. Maybe you backslid and you had that relationship, and maybe you want to get that relationship now. Or I simply email us at firstchurchofsocialmedia@gmail.com. Maybe you want to be a part of this ministry. We would be love to have you. We need help out here loading this plane up so we can get ready to take off to our destiny, our destination. Simply email us at firstchurchofsocialmedia@gmail.com. Maybe you want to sow a seed today. We'd love to have you sow a seed. There's two ways you can sow a seed. The first way is simply Cash App us, $FCOSM. Again, that's $FCOSM. Second way is simply text. That's right, text. Text the word give, G-I-V-E, the number 2, F-C-S-M. You text this to 77977. Again, you can simply text the word give, G-I-V-E, the number 2, F-C-S-M. You text this to 77977. Again, thank you all for joining us today. We love you all. May his grace cover you throughout this week. And remember that while you're sitting on the tarmac and you're going through the turbulence and the turmoil, remember, all things work together for your good. God bless you all. I love you.